Good morning, everyone. A very good morning to you all. Hope you all are good and doing good. Children, we have started chapter number 5, the fractions, in the previous class. Today, we will continue with the same lesson and few topics ahead. First, before I move ahead, I'll just revise what we have studied that day. That day we have studied the fractions, what are fractions and how do we write it. So what we have learned is, fraction is a part of a whole or a collection or a group. It is a part of a whole, or you can say it is a part of a group or a collection. And the parts which we are making or which we are using should be equal. Now, and how do we write it? For writing a fraction, there are two numbers used. One is, this is your fraction bar or division bar. One number is written over this fraction bar and the other one is written below it. This is how you write a fraction. The number which is written above the bar is called numerator, and the number which is written below the bar is called as the denominator. I hope this much you have revised, this much we have done in the previous class. Now we will move further. The next topic which we will be discussing is the types of fractions. On the basis of this numerator and the denominator, we have divided, or we can say there are three types of fractions. How many types of fractions? So we will deal with types of fractions. Okay, there are three types of fraction. The first is the proper fraction. I'll take one by one. Okay, so proper fraction is a fraction in which the numerator is smaller than the denominator. I'll just explain. See, suppose I write a fraction like this, 3/5, 1/7 and 9/13, 65/90. Now if you observe them, this is numerator, this is denominator, all this. Now see here, this 3 is less than 5. Here 1 is less than 7, 9 is less than 13 and 65 is less than 90. That means in all these cases, the numerators are smaller than the denominator. Such fractions in which the numerators are smaller than the denominator, they are called as proper fraction. Second thing what you have to remember is, the proper fractions are always smaller than 1. The first point is that proper fraction, numerator is smaller than denominator. I am writing the short forms of this, okay? And the second point which you will remember of this is that the proper fraction will always be smaller than 1. Is it clear? Okay, I'll read it from the book also. The defines are given in there. This is page number 58. Proper fraction, the fraction in which the numerator is smaller than the denominator is called proper fraction. The examples are given: 2/3, 4/7, 3/10, etc. Then, the fraction in which the numerator is greater than or equal to. Children, remember one thing. So that we will move now. No, just now we will do this. So this is the example. Now we move on to the second type, and that is improper fraction. Second type is your improper fraction. I write over here second type, and this is improper fraction. improper fraction. Improper fraction is a fraction in which the denominator is smaller than the numerator. The reverse of the proper fraction. If suppose I write 9 upon 7, 35 upon 10, 96 upon 80, or anything, you can write down like this. In these cases, the numerators are greater than the denominators. Such fractions are called improper fractions. This is your, the what point you will remember? In this, the numerator is greater than denominator. And the second thing which you will remember, it will be greater or it may be equal also. Suppose if I take this 21 upon 21, both the numerator and denominators are same. That is also an improper fraction. If I take another example, 72 upon 72, total number of parts about the number of parts we are using. So it is also an improper fraction. So first thing, if numerator is greater than or than denominator or equal to denominator, then it is improper fraction. The third type is your mixed fraction. Mixed fraction is, if I just read it from the book, a mixed fraction is a combination of a whole number and a proper fraction. A mixed fraction is a combination of a whole number and a proper fraction. Mixed fraction are always greater than one. Okay? So, what you will see over here, mixed fraction, suppose I write down 3 upon 1, this, then I take 4, 2, 9, like this. Now, this is called as mixed fraction. See, this number is your whole number. This number is your whole number. And this is your proper fraction. So, it is a combination of the whole number and the proper fractions. Clear? So, have a look at it. So, this much is clear to everyone. Now, another thing which you will be remembering, so first will be, it is a combination of a whole number and a proper fraction. And the second thing which you will remember about this is, it will be always be greater than 1. Will always be greater than 1. Hope this much is clear to you. Now, you are clear with the proper, improper and the mixed fraction. Now, whenever you get any mixed fraction, you have to solve it. You have to convert it into first the improper fractions. And how we do it? I'll show. So, the next is expressing an improper fraction as a mixed fraction. So, children, the next topic, are three types of fractions we have studied, out of which we will study the mixed fraction in a little detail. And what is that? Suppose this is expressing the improper fraction. Suppose I take number, this is 14 upon 5. This is improper. Why? Because numerator is greater than the denominator. Now, when such sums come, you have to solve them, you have to convert them into mixed fraction. And how you convert them? In the rough column, or when you are thorough with this, you can orally do it. Otherwise, what you do, you take 14 as the dividend and this as the divisor, the denominator as the divisor. Now, does 14 come in table of 5? No. So, 5 twos are 10. Okay. This is how you will solve it. Now, once you have solved it, what you will write down? Now, see into the book. It is given same as 14 upon 5 as a mixed fraction. Divide the numerator by the denominator. You get 2 this as a quotient. 4 is the remainder and the 5 is your denominator. In every improper fraction, when you convert into mixed fraction, this you have to do. Now, this portion which you get will become your whole number. The remainder will become the numerator and the divisor will become the denominator remains the same. The quotient which you get will become the whole number and the remainder will become the numerator and this divisor will become the denominator, which is same. That means, what is the formula for it? Now, this is clear how you have to do it. I'll take another example. Suppose I take 23 upon 7. How I will do it? This is numerator is greater than the denominator. That means it is an improper fraction. I will solve it in the rough. 23, 7, 3s are 21, 0. So what is your quotient? 3. So this becomes your whole number. Remainder becomes your numerator and divisor becomes your denominator, which is same as this. This is clear? Then the next in this is expressing the mixed fraction as the improper fraction. Expressing the mixed fraction as improper fraction. This is the reverse of this. Suppose I take the same example. You have taken this is 3, 2 upon 7. This is your mixed fraction because this is your whole number. This is your proper fraction. Numerator is smaller than the denominator. Now what you do? You multiply. Sorry, this is not working. You multiply this denominator with this whole number. You multiply this denominator with the whole number and whatever the answer is, you will add this numerator to it. Now, I'll show it. 7 3s are 21 plus 2 is 23 and the denominator remains the same. This is your answer. I'll take another example. Suppose I take 2, 3 upon 5. This is the first example. This is the second. 5, 2's are 10. 10 and plus 3 is 13 will become your numerator and the denominator remains the same. Clear? So what formula here we are using? We are multiplying the denominator with the whole number and we are adding the numerator. Denominator, we are multiplying with the whole number and we are adding the numerator and below the denominator remains the same. I hope this much is clear to everyone. Have a look. Clear? Now before this, we move on to exercise 5.2. Exercise 5.2. As usually, children, I'll be doing some sums on the board. The remaining sums, please do practice in your copies. Until and unless you practice, you will not be able to solve them. So we move on to exercise 5.2. See the first one, identify the proper, improper and the mixed fraction. You can do this in the book. First one, if you see, it is 3 upon 7. The numerator is smaller than the denominator. So, it is a proper fraction. When you get it in the exam or anything, you have to write like this, full. Then, say the second one. This was your first one. Question number 1. It is 14 upon 11. The numerator is greater than the denominator. So, it is improper. improper fraction. Then see the third one. In this, a whole number is given and the numerator and the, that is the proper fraction. So it is a mixed fraction. This way you have to do it in the book, in front of it only. The fourth one is again proper. The next is proper. Sixth one is improper. Now comes the seventh one. See the seventh one. It is 12 upon 12. That means numerator is equals to the denominator. So this is also improper. When the numerator is same as denominator, it is also improper fraction. So this way you have to do remaining one, you will be doing in your copy. Then question number 2, express the shaded as the mixed. So I'll rub it. Question number 2, in this the figures are given and looking at those figures, you have to give the answer. Express the shaded part as a mixed fraction. So children, if you look into the book, there are four parts are given. So four things are given, out of which in every the three are shaded. So what will be the fraction for it? Three are completely shaded. Then see the last one, in this only two are shaded. Out of the three, two are shaded. So this will be your answer. Then this was your question number 2, first one. In the second one, there are, you can say, three triangles, you can say. And in each one, the three parts are, first and second, the three parts are shaded. In the last one, only one part is shaded. So for the first and the second one, we will write 2, 1 plus 1, 2. And in the second one, it will be 1 out of the 3 is shaded. Then similarly the third one, there are, you can say, four umbrellas, you can say. The first three are totally shaded and the fourth one only one part is not shaded. So in that case, three are completely shaded. So that is your whole number. And out of the four one, if there are eight parts and seven are shaded, it is like this. Hope it is clear. Now the next question is by proper fraction. Children, here what they want to say is that if you have to make such fractions in which when you add the numerator to the denominator, the answer is 10. So how we will make it, we will see here. So we will start up from 0 upon 10. If you add the 0 and 10, it becomes 10 only. Then 1 upon 9, 9 and 1 is 10. 2 upon 8, 8 and 2 is 10. Then 3 upon 7, 7 and 3 is 10. Then 4 upon 6, 6 and 4 is 10. Then 5 upon 5, although it is 10, but it becomes 1. So that means these are the fractions we can make. When you we add numerator to the denominator, the answer is 10. This is how you have to do it. Then the next sum. Insert greater is equals to or smaller in the box. See the first one, question number 4. In this one, then there is a box, then 3 upon 11. 3 upon 11 is a proper fraction. And on the other side it is 1. So that means it is bigger. So the first answer is this. In the second one, see, one side 1 is written, then the box, and then it is 14 upon 9. Okay. Now when we solve this 14 upon 9, this is greater, this is bigger than 1. So it will be like this. You solve it, you convert it into mixed fraction. Mixed fraction is always greater than 1. And the third one is equals to, because it is 1. And it is 105 upon 105. 105 is already 1. So it is equal. Okay. Then we move on to the next question. Next question, question number 5. Express the improper fraction as the mixed fraction. In this, you will be doing in the book only. See the first one, 8 upon 5. Now, this is improper. The numerator is greater than the denominator. So, you will divide it in the rough and you will get the answer. If I solve it 1, the dividend 5. 5 ones are 5. So, quotient becomes your whole number. Remainder becomes your numerator. And this is your divisor. So, this is your answer. Same way, the next one, if this was your first one, same way if I do second one, it is 19 upon 2. Children, if I write it like this, divide it, you can do it in the rough or directly if you know it, 2 nines are 18 and it is 1. So, it is your, 2 is your whole number, 9 is your whole number. 1 upon 2 is your answer. This is, the quotient becomes your whole number, the remainder becomes the numerator, and the divisor becomes the denominator. I'll do another one for you. 17 upon 3. Now you know 17 doesn't come in table of 3, so it can be 3 fives are 15. And if you subtract 15 from 17, 2 is left. So it is 2 upon 3 is your answer. Question number 6 is just the reverse of this. In this, the mixed fractions are given and you have to write the improper fraction. This is question number 6. I'll do the one for you. It is 2 upon 7. Now what formula did I teach you? You will multiply the denominator with the whole number and you will add this numerator to the answer. 7 twos are 14. 14 and plus 2 is 16 upon 7 is your answer. Next I'll do another one. It is 4 whole number 1 upon 9. Again 9 fours are 36. We will multiply this and we add this, so it will be 37 upon 9. Denominator will remain the same. Then 3 whole number 2 upon 5. 5 threes are 15 and 2 is 17 upon 5. So this is your answer. In this way you will be doing the remaining sums in your copies. Now the next one is fractions on number line. So, the next is fractions on number line. We'll be doing two types, proper fraction and mixed and improper fraction. How do you represent a fraction on the number line? You all are familiar with number line. Okay, in this we will be only doing the positive side of this number line. So, in this what you do, whatever the fraction is given, you will first draw the number line. Whatever the fraction is given, you will first see the denominator. Or you first see the numerator. For the proper fractions we will deal first. In the proper fraction the numerator will be smaller than the denominator. So you will draw the number line and you will divide it into equal parts according to the denominator. Whatever is the denominator, you will divide the number line into equal parts. I will give a very example from the book only. It is 3 upon 4. Now children, 3 upon 4, this is a proper fraction, that means it is less than 1. So that means whatever the fractions we will be making over here, they will always be, all will be less than 1. Now then you will see the denominator. How much it is? Denominator is 4. Suppose I draw this number line. Now I know that this number will be lying between 0 and 1. That is for sure, this will be lying in between this. Now what is the denominator over here? 4. So I will draw 4 equal parts. Okay, I will be drawing this four equal parts. So you can clearly see there are four equal parts, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now if I write the fraction, this will be 0 upon 4, this will be 1 upon 4, this will be 2 upon 4, this will be 3 upon 4, and this will be 4 upon 4. This is equals to 1 only, so we will not write the fraction over there. We are simply writing 1. So once we have divided according to the denominator, we have divided this into 4 parts. Now we move on to number, how much is written on the denominator. So we will move from 0. We will move from 0, and this is how it is, 3 upon 4. Clear? In the same way, when we will be doing for mixed or the improper fraction, it will be drawn like this only, but it will be always more than 1. It will not be between 0 and 1, but it will be after this for the improper or the mixed fraction. Clear? So we'll move on to exercise. Now before that, I will read it. Divide the gap between, for the proper fraction, divide the gap between 0 and 1 into as many parts as the denominator of the fractions. And see for the mixed and the improper fraction. Improper fraction can be represented on the number line by converting it into a mixed fraction. And then divide the gap between 1 and 2 in equal parts as the example is given. The last line of this, very important in the bold letters. Infinite number of fractions can lie between 2 consecutive whole numbers. There can be as many fractions in between the 2 whole numbers. Okay, then the second, we move on to exercise 5.3. Okay. 5.3, in the first one, which of the number line represents the mark point as 2 upon 6? If you write this on the number line, all the numbers, you will see the second one is correct because the 0 is given. Then the first part will be 1 upon 6. Second part, x is 2 upon 6. Then 3 upon 6, 4 upon 6, 5 upon 6. And it will the 1, the 6 upon 6, that is 1. That means second one is correct. Now mark the fractions on number line. I'll be doing 2 for you. Then the rest you can practice in your practice copy. So question number 2. Exercise 5.3, the second sum, 3 upon 8. I draw this number line. Now you know this is a proper fraction. The numerator is smaller than the denominator. That means it will be between 0 and 1 only. So I write 0, suppose I write 1 over. Now, what is the denominator over here? 8. So that means I will be dividing this into 8 parts, equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Almost equal. Now I put down the values or the fractions. So it will be 0 upon 8, 1 upon 8, 2 upon 8, 3, 4 upon 8, 5 upon 8, 6 upon 8, 7 upon 8, and this is 8 upon 8, that is 1. Now, what is the numerator here? So, we move to, so this is your number. Clear? Then, I'll be showing this one. See children, fourth one. In the fourth one, it is 7 upon 6. It is an improper. So you will first convert into mixed fraction. So it will be, 1 will be a whole number. 1 upon 6 will be the answer. Then you will show this on the number line. Clear? Now how we will show? I'll just show it. Ninth one for you. It is 1, 4 upon 7. 1 whole number, 4 upon 7. Now children, this is mixed fraction. This is already 1, that means it will be greater than 1. So what we will do, we will draw the number line. This is 0. Now this shows this is the whole number is 1. That means this fraction lies between 1 and 2. It will be greater than 1 and it lies between 1 and 2. Suppose I draw it like this, 1, and this is almost equal 2. Now what is the denominator over here? So I will be dividing this part into 7 equal parts. This is the denominator 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Then it will be, sorry, this is 1, so 1 whole number 1 upon 7, 1 2 upon 7, 1 3 upon 7, 1 4 upon 7, 1 5 upon 7, then 1 6 upon 7, and then it will become like this, because it will be 7 upon 7, so it will become 2. Now we move on to, this is numerator is 4. So clear? Hope this is clear to everyone. This way you have to do it. Then see the next one. Correct the wrongly marked fractions on the number line. So after 0 you will start from 1 upon 7, then 2 upon 7. Correct them. Cut them and write the new one. 1 upon 7, 2 upon 7, 3 upon 7, 4 upon 7, 5 upon 7, 6 upon 7, and then 7 upon 7 becomes 1. So with this we finish today's session. Hope you all have understood well. Look at the video carefully afterwards and then practice the sums. Stay safe and take care.